Hi guys, I'm Srishti and I'm here with another topic of finance current affair. So you must have seen in the headlines of almost every newspaper that RBI has cut its repo rate again, but this time by 35 basis points. Standard 25 basis points. Yeah. So today we are going to discuss the reasons and the impact of a repo rate cut by 35 BPS. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel for regular updates. So continuing with the document, firstly, as we know that everyone was expecting a 25 basis points of cut in the repo rate by RBI, but this time RBI has cut the rate by 35 BPS. So from the beginning of the year, RBI has cut its repo rate thrice by 25 basis points each time, making it a 75 BPS cut. And now after this 35 BPS cut, the total cut which has been done is by 110 BPS, making the repo rate to 5.4%. Now what are the implications and the aftermath on various areas by the repo rate cut? So we are going to discuss this in brief here. So following a rate cut, SBI has immediately reduced its MCLR by 15 basis points. So what will be the impact of the action which SBI took? Now other banks which are also the lenders will also now be forced to reduce their MCLR to compete in the market, because if one competitor, which is SBI, has reduced its MCLR, that is its lending rate, by 15 basis points, and if all the other banks, say HDFC or ICICI, if they are operating at the same MCLR, then who will go and borrow from these banks? Everyone will get attracted to SBI because now it has a lower MCLR. So this will force another banks like HDFC and ICICI to come at par with SBI, or not to say at par, so to reduce its repo rate so that its borrowers, its customers does not get diverted to other banks. Now a valid question which arises here is that despite of MCLR being linked to repo rate, why is the transmission not happening? The transmission of the monetary policy is not happening. As we can see, the borrowers are not getting a reduced MCLR, and we know that MCLR being linked to repo rate, then why a bank has to reduce its MCLR? It should be automatic and immediate. The transmission should be immediate so that the borrowers could get benefit from this. So the answer here is that although the marginal cost of funds, it is linked to repo rate and it is superior to the earlier base rate system, but there is no complete transmission even in the MCLR system also. Why? Because it is based on the internal benchmark. So if I say internal benchmark, I mean that even though the repo rate is reducing, the banks could raise another sources of their cost, such as the operating cost and many other interest rates which they incur to mobilize the funds. So these costs vary from banks to banks, and that is why MCLR is an internal benchmark rate and there is no full transmission of the monetary policy to the borrowers. Also, in my previous video, I have talked about the credit deposit ratio. So what is CDR? As we all know, that the loans given by a bank upon the deposits which it gets. So as CDR is around 76.3%, and in the video I have told you that all the deposits which a bank gets, it is able to give them as loans. So then why would a bank be interested to lower the interest rates? So this is another reason that why the transmission is not happening, because MCLR is internal benchmark, first point. Second point is that the CDR is 76.3%, which means that if a bank is getting 76 as loans, then it is able to get. So this means that if a bank is getting 100 rupees as loans, then after 4 as CRR and 18.75 as SLR, keeping this money aside, the deposits, the funds which are left with the bank, it is able to give it as loans. So what will be the suggestion? That the RBI should consider converting this internal benchmark rate to an external benchmark rate, so that a complete benefit of the monetary policy transmission could be experienced by the ultimate borrowers. For this, the RBI has given three things: either the repo rate or the treasury bill yield, the base rate or the external benchmark rates, or the CD, which is the certificate of deposits. So by converting from the internal benchmark to the external benchmark, there will be a complete transmission of the lowering repo rate. So moving on to another point, RBI has done a very smart move that it has cut the risk weight of the consumer loans to 100% from 125%. So as we all know, when a bank lends, it has to maintain some capital in its backing based on the risk weight it associates to the loan it is lending to the borrower. So when the risk weight which a bank could lend to a consumer, the risk weight is reduced from 125% to 100%. So there will be some amount of free capital with the banks, and with that free capital, bank can give more loans or the same amount of loans at a lower rate. So this is a big push and a very effective push towards growth. Now the next thing is the benefit is given to the NBFC sector. So earlier a bank could lend up to 15% from its tier 1 capital to a single NBFC borrower. But now this limit of 15% has increased to 20%. So this will solve the liquidity problem of the NBFCs. Also, as we all know, there are PSL norms, that is priority sector lending norms, according to which a bank has to do some priority sector lending. So those sectors are agriculture, MSME, housing, export credit, education, social infrastructure, and renewable energy. So these are all the priority sector areas, out of which RBI has focused on the agriculture, MSME and housing, as we can see here. So what RBI has done is that now the banks can fulfill their priority sector obligations by loaning to NBFCs who then on-lend. Notice the word on-lend here. On-lend them to agriculture up to rupees 10 lakhs and MSME or the affordable home buyers up to rupees 20 lakhs. So this is done in order to promote the credit growth in India. Now what is the impact on the bond market? So as we all know, there are two types of securities, the short-term securities and the long-term securities. So we know that the short-term securities are the ones like commercial papers and the government securities. So they have already been repriced to the markets according to the expectation of the yield. But in case of long-term yields, the 10-year yield have gone up when it should have gone down. So why it has gone up? The reasons are very interesting here, that investors are risk averse amid the uncertainty, and that is why they have increased their credit risk and their premium. So as a result, the yield goes up. Yield means the required rate of return by the investors. So investors are preferring safe government bonds or the plain fixed deposits and cash. So that is why on the long term securities, the yield has gone up. It is also very interesting to note that the yields on AAA rated corporate bonds, AAA rated companies are very high rated companies, they are the blue chip companies. So AAA rated corporate bonds have hardly reacted. So what will be the implication of this? That the companies are now going to get long-term funds at a higher cost of borrowing despite a reduction in the repo rate cut. Because the yield expected by the investors are increasing, that is why the cost of borrowing for the companies will also be high. Now, as we can see that beginning from this year, there is a repo rate cut made by the RBI thrice by 25 BPS. Then why not now it has done of 25 BPS cut, rather it has switched to 35 BPS cut. So governor of RBI defended this and he said that the standard 25 BPS cut that might be very inadequate to solve the macroeconomic problems or to solve the liquidity crunch problems. On the other hand, reducing the policy repo rate cut by as high as 50 BPS, that might be very excessive. And let me tell you, on hearing this line, the investors rose their yield when they should have gone down. So therefore, by reducing the policy rate cut by 35 BPS, it was viewed as a balanced level of cut. Now the criticism which are there is that market is confused that why only 35 BPS cut, or market is finding it difficult to interpret this 35 BPS, what lies so special in this figure 35 BPS, why not 34 BPS or 36 BPS. Also, the Monetary Policy Committee, it has been given the flexibility to decide the policy repo rate cut, but that doesn't mean that it infuses confusion in the market, and because of this confusion only the uncertainty among the investors rose and as a result the yields rose. So these are all the criticisms of the action taken by the RBI. So with this we have discussed that what are the impacts of a RBI repo rate cut by 35 BPS. I hope that you all are able to understand this concept. So this is a very important topic for RBI and SEBI grade examinations. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching it.